gone for Apollo 11. Now 5 minutes, 52 seconds and counting.
My name's Todd Douglas Miller and I'm the director of Apollo 11.
DTSC, verify go for launch.
Booster flight.
Verify go for launch. SRO, verify go for launch.
We had made connections with NASA and the National Archives, also our archive producing team. They had all alerted me to the possibility of doing an Apollo 11. We've all seen Apollo 11 imagery. We've seen this small postage size stamp before. About 3-4 months into the project, one of the supervisory archivists told us about this discovery of the large format collection. These reels have been sitting in cold storage in pristine condition for the better half of 50 years. It wasn't until we actually took several reels to New York, threw them on a film scanner, and it was jaw-dropping to say the least. I've heard people describe being in the room, Spielberg and others, when they first saw the Jurassic Park dinosaurs on a computer screen for the first time. And that's probably the closest approximation I could give. There was 3 or 4 of us in the room. We just stood there in awe. We made sure the door was locked. And we were just absolutely astonished. It was incredible. Probably one of the scenes that always got me was the suiting up shots. And they're just absolutely stunning in their quality. But what really got me was how emotional the astronauts were and the looks on their faces. To see it in that kind of a quality, the entire weight of what they're about to do is written on their face. To see that stoic look just hits you. Right before the Sundance premiere, we had showed Buzz Aldrin, and it was terrifying. But luckily, he loved it, you know, and once the movie started, he, you know, put on his glasses. He was just like locked in the entire time, and everybody that was with him, it was just a very moving and an emotional experience. And in fact, that screening, I really recognized that we had really done something extraordinary. It was kind of the first time where we all just kind of breathed a sigh of relief. That was real validation that he accepted it.
This is Apollo Saturn launch control, T-minus 1 minute, 35 seconds.
Very early on, we knew that we wanted to make the most accurate sound of a Saturn V rocket launch. If you talk to people in the space community, they say, no one's ever done it. We said, well, we're gonna do it. It took a long time. We had Neil Armstrong's sons there, Rick and Mark, who were on the Banana River on a boat during the actual launch with their mom. Rick Armstrong himself said it was the closest that anyone's come before, which was very gratifying.
Apollo 11, Houston, we are go for undocking, over.
A lot of our work with the team, we've been influencing the historical record. It's been a nice byproduct of the film to the point where we're still working on it, and that's become a bigger project. A big part of our project is to document exactly what we're doing so future filmmakers and future people won't have to kind of guess where, you know, all this stuff is happening. When you look at the film, we wanted it to be technically accurate and also entertaining and inspiring. And if people can use our film as a primer for future space travel, that would be pretty awesome.